I think China's growth model of the last 30 years is broken. Okay? The country can no longer rely on low-end manufacturing and export for growth. Chinese workers don't want to slave away for low wages anymore, and there's just too much pollution in the country. So the government is trying to push the country more towards innovation. But there are really three major barriers that are continuing to challenge and slow the growth of innovation in the country. The first is the government. Okay, a lot of the government bureaucracy has to get a lot better at streamlining approval processes and really at the local level promoting innovation. I think the central government gets it, but the local governments don't always. The second is the education system. Right now, the education system focuses too much on rote memory, so it's not really teaching the creative risk-taking that you need for an entrepreneurship class that you need for innovation. And then the third thing is exits, okay? You know, entrepreneurs and the venture capitalists alike need to understand that you can make more money by focusing on innovation than copying the same old business models of the last 30 years. But you're starting to see it. You're starting to see some entrepreneurs have become billionaires in the last couple years by building innovative companies, especially in tech services. And so that's where the VC money and that's where the entrepreneurs are sort of heading right now. Yeah, I think, you know, over the last 30 years, China has been more of a copycat country than one focus on innovation. And that really made sense, okay? When you look at it, China's economy in the late 1970s, before it opened up to the world, was really poor. It was chaotic. You know, during the Cultural Revolution, business and education was basically banned at a higher level. So in order for China to really build, it needed to focus on copycatting, business models, transferring technology, or even an outright intellectual property theft. And that really made sense, low end. But now, as the economy slows, and we're now hitting sort of a new normal, instead of 10 to 11% growth, we're now having, you know, 6, 7% growth. The country and the businesses need to focus on moving up the value chain and moving on to innovation. So when you have, when you start from such a low base, like they did 30 years ago, copycat made sense. Now, as the profitability on industrial profits are dropping, you need to focus on innovation. I think you're starting to see that. You see companies like Huawei or Lenovo are some of the most innovative companies in the world, and that's on the hardware side. When you go into services on mobile, companies like Tencent, you know, the founder of WeChat, really are sort of light years ahead of American companies in Silicon Valley in terms of innovation. Well, I think the first sector that's seeing a lot of advancements is mobile, okay? So like I said, mobile services in China are really 2-3 years ahead of what you get in the United States. And that's because you get most people in China access the internet from a mobile phone. They never access from a PC. So what you're seeing is companies in the United States like Twitter or Facebook were created for the PC environment, and they've tried to port those experiences to the mobile phone. It doesn't always work seamlessly, but the Chinese mobile players are building with the mobile phone and mobile devices from the very beginning. So mobile, I'm extremely bullish on. The second area is industrial companies. You know, companies like Shugong or Zoomline and construction equipment, they're starting to compete with the big American players or European ones like a Siemens or a Terex, not just on price, but actually on quality. And they're saying we're as good, if not better, and we might even be a little bit cheaper. But they're really doing very well in industrial. And then third, the area where I'm most excited is basically biotechnology. Okay, the government is extremely supportive of biotech. They're putting in billions of dollars. They're getting universities to work with entrepreneurs in sort of these biotech tech parks. And they're really easing some of the requirements for startups. So I think, you know, if you're in biotech, you know, and you're an entrepreneur, China might very well be the best place in the world to start a company right now.